Hey there everyone, Hitesh here, back again with another video, and in this video, I want to give you a tip about programming. Now, this is an advice that I would like to share to you because recently in this month only, we have hosted like 5 or 6 seminars and like 5 and 6 workshop, kind of a bootcamp training in a variety of colleges. And I want to just address this issue, which I have seen common in all of the places, including IITs, NITs, and other private universities where we have visited. When you want to learn programming, you are passionate about it. You extremely feel happy that I'm learning something from which I'm able to do something. I'm able to solve a problem, whether that's a mobile app through machine learning or whatever that is. And when you see all these other people, they're having some partners, maybe a friend, maybe a colleague who is able to work with him along with that. You also, it's a tendency that you also seek for some partner for some help that, hey, my best friend should also program with me or write some code with me. And that's not always the case. And in fact, you should be extra cautious while choosing a partner in the programming because that can take you to the next level, but also can bring you down to one level. So be a little bit cautious. And let me explain these scenarios where I've seen people going down and going up in the same case and same workshops. Now, during these boot camps and events, I've seen that sometimes people choose a partner or a friend for learning programming. And they say, hey, there's a workshop happening up, so do you want to join up? And since the friend is going, you also go up there and try to just go there. Now, one friend is super passionate about learning that particular subject. He's going crazy about it. He wants to work really hard. But the other person who is just here and who is saying, yeah, it's just okay, I'm not that much interested. But you know, I'm interested in basketball. Now, I'm not saying the other person who is interested in sport is bad or something. No, you just have got different choices and different life goals. So definitely you can be friend. You can be friends at that time, but understand this thing that what is your passion is not somebody else's passion. So choose it wisely. Don't force the programming on other friends, or you should also not force basketball or whatever you are passionate about on other person as well. But make sure you just choose the things and situation here wisely, because that person, you're passionate about programming, you want to learn more, you want to spend more time with computer, but other friend is dragging you outside. That might be good, might not be good, but let's just say you have X amount of time in a day that you want to dedicate only for programming or whatever you are passionate about. So these are the situations where somebody can drag you down a little bit. I'm not saying one is wrong or one is right, but make sure you are always not dependent on a person when you want to learn something, because let me be honest here, when you want to buy something, you want to buy an awesome new car, nobody's going to come up and pay your EMI with that. When you want to give your dad an amazing gift, an awesome new car, and want to see the shine in your dad's eye, there is not going to be anybody who is going to give you that, hey, take this amount of money and I'm not going to ask it back. So life is a little bit hard on that side. And whatever you are going to be doing, it's going to be on your own. So it's not like you are always able to find any partner in that. It's sometimes just you, and maybe some partner will be there for you in the future, some colleague, some teammate. So it's not about the day you get started, you find somebody to code along with you. It's not like that. Sometimes you don't find that. Scenario number two, which is like the most disastrous thing that you can do with your partner. Let's just say you are two partners, and I've seen this situation in a boot camp as well. Now, let's just say you are two partners. Your one partner is amazing in coding. He is super amazing. He just writes the code, whatever the challenge is thrown in front of him, and he just is able to solve that. And on the other hand, you are a decent programmer. You are definitely good, but not as good as he is. Now, what I've seen in such cases and scenarios that sometimes when your partner is just finished with the job or the project, just see his screen and say, yeah, it was easy, I can also do that. But what mistake you are doing, you are not writing that code on yourself, and you are not challenging yourself to just finish that code on your own. And until and unless you're going to write your own code, you're never going to learn coding. The important part is coding is just like mathematics. It seems all easy when somebody else is doing, but it can be a little bit challenging when you do it on your own. So make sure if you're choosing a partner who is amazing than you and he writes better code or faster code than you, you don't just rely totally on him, because what is going to happen, eventually the gap will grow up. And what will happen at the end of the bootcamp or the workshop is your partner will be able to just go on to the next level while you will get onto one lower level because your confidence now is a little bit onto the bad side. And I have seen this exact same situation number of times. One situation, one where one is passionate about coding, other one is just not that much. And he drags the person out somewhere and later on you found yourself in trouble. And on the other hand, both are passionate about programming. One is super amazing, but second one is just relied on the other person. Remember one thing always, it's gonna be you, it's gonna be your laptop, it's gonna be your code editor, it's gonna be just you who is going to make something, who is going to build something. Companies are going to pay you only, not your friend. So there will be job and task for you, and there will be job and task for your friend as well. So don't just rely on anybody, make good friends. I'm not saying don't just leave those friends, make them good friends, stay around with them, hang around with them, but make sure when it comes to learning, it should be personal, it should be private. Unless you are able to do it, don't just say that, hey, my friend has done it, so I'm happy with it, I'm good at it. It's working on a screen, so I'm happy with it, I'm fine with this. It doesn't work like that. So whole story short, promise yourself one thing, one very important thing, that no matter what I'm learning, from which workshop I'm learning, from which bootcamp I'm learning, on what institution I'm going to learn, until and unless it works on your computer, you are not able to write it, it's not done. The job is not done. If your friend is done with the job, if your friend has completed the challenge, he is done, not you. And yes, on top of that, I do agree that it's a little bit tough at the initial phase to find equally passionate programmers or in the subject domain as well. You can definitely find people who are generally interested in programming, but let's just say your interest is either in machine learning or maybe web or Android. So other person are gonna force you or will encourage you to just get into their domain. No, it's not like that. Just pick up your domain personally and you just want to hang around with that. I'm not saying again, I know it. This video can be easily misinterpreted as, hey, I'm saying something that don't hang around with friends or something. I still hang around and some of my best friends are from commerce stream. They don't even know what programming is, but I still hang around with them on every single Sunday. So make sure you get the point of this whole video. Choose your friends wisely and don't just get too much dependent on them. It's your passion. It's something that you want to follow. Hang around with them, but make sure you don't compromise in the time that you want to dedicate totally on learning thing. They are your good friend. They shall remain your good friend in the future as well. But something that you're passionate about is also something that should count. I will be sharing more such experiences from workshops and talks that I'm doing in colleges all over the India, and I'm also getting some invites abroad as well. I will be taking some of them. Some of them will be taken care of by my team as well. I'm super happy to share such experience, and in the future also, I will be sharing such experiences with you. I think these experiences makes you a better programmer and a better person as well. And I think some of you are really interested in knowing such kind of experiences as well. Let me know in the comment section if this video is helping you and I should make more such videos or not. And one thing, definitely consider subscribing this channel. That's it for this video. I'll surely catch you up in the next video.